أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ورتل القرآن ترتيلا.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Okay, this is lesson 42, and this lesson is quite easy but very important, very significant, because it is related to the rules of pause, rules of stop, ahkamul waqf. You see, at-tarteel has two parts, two distinctive parts. One is at-tarteel has been defined as tajweedul huruf wa ma'rifatul wuquf. Tajweedul huruf means there is a clear and precise pronunciation of each and every letter of Arabic used in the Holy Quran, and we know there are 29 similar sounding letters. Each letter must be pronounced or read with its due properties and qualities, thick and thin, you know, how it is going to be pronounced. And the second very important point is about ma'rifatul wuquf, recognition about the pauses, where to stop, how to stop, and where to start, and how to start. Okay, so this is very important. If a person is not well aware about the rules of pause, his recitation is not complete. Now, there are many cases, the word endings are different, starting from Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim up to Minal Jinnati Wan Nas. There are various examples, and they have been categorized into, let's see, about 20 cases, and we are going to explore only 8 cases today. You know, the word ending and how to stop there and then to start. Case 1, there will be no change if the last letter is sakin. In this lesson I would be listening to you. Okay, so basically I'm in a listening mode and you are in a reciting mode. So there will be no change if the last letter is sakin. You can find here the 4 example. Far, ghab, ba with original sukoon. Khalat, sukoon is there. Jazm, asmi', ayn is there. And then ha with the proper, you know, the sukoon. Now, only because of the shortage of time, we have to cover many examples in these 8 cases, and many to follow in the forthcoming lessons. Each one is required only recite one line, okay, with applying all the rules. Remember, this time we are now coming to the conclusion of this programs, and you have to apply all the learnt rules and safely ending, as has been mentioned on the top. There will be no change. Okay, but at the same time you have to apply all the rules. For example, on far, ghab, now ba with sukoon, and you must remember what is going to happen with the ba, with this, a sukoon or jazm. Qalqala sound is a bouncing sound, echo sound. Okay, let's start with Hasan. A'udhu billah.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وإلى ربك فارغب.
No, one again, that mistake. I've just told you about that one.
Yeah, right.
وإلى ربك, you have done very well, but at the end you stopped, but you ignored important point of recitation, rule of recitation, which you learned in the very beginning. Do again.
Oh, I did it. وَإِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ فَرَغَبَ.
Yes, that's fine. Okay. Now it is quite clear. Okay. Okay, next example.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم تلك أمة قد خلت.
Good. Okay. Do you agree? Okay, Zishan, next.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم أبصر به وأسمع.
Good. Next.
أولئك الذين هدى الله فبهداهم اقتده.
Okay, well done. This time, you know, applied all the rules, and also you took care about the second letter of ulaika. This vowel is should be pronounced or silent?
Silent.
You did?
Yeah.
Good. Well done. Case 2. There will be no change if a consonant is followed by alif madda. How many letters of madda? How many letters of prolongation?
Three.
Zishan?
Three.
Three. Which are they?
Alif, wow, and ya.
Wow, alif, wow, and ya. In here, in all these four examples, the last word is ending on alif madda. So alif madda means the letter of prolongation, which is alif, that will be pronounced. And because of the waqf, you can prolong. It should be taken as a madda. You can, you know, you can stretch that alif up to three counts, four counts, and five counts, you know, depending on the mode of recitation in which you are reciting. You know, is a slow recitation, stretched recitation, or a medium recitation, or a quicker recitation. You see, there are different modes depending on, you know, where you are reciting the Holy Quran. So do Hasan, you do this one.
وَقَالُوا سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا.
Good, well done. Rahman.
رَبَّنَا لَا تُؤَاخِذْنَا إِن نَسِينَا أَوْ أَخْطَأْنَا.
Well done. Ishan.
وَالنَّهَارِ إِذَا جَلَّاهَا.
Again, another example.
بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى لَهَا.
Noon, مُشَدَّد. Hint.
بِأَنَّ رَبَّكَ أَوْحَى لَهَا.
Well done. On ba with a shadda, with tashdeed, shadda, رَبَّكَ. You know, with thick. Raw is a thick. But ba with full mouth, you know, a little bit stress more. Anyway, it's okay. Bi anna rabbaka awha laha. Okay, good. Case 3. There will be no change if a consonant is followed by waw madda. Alif madda, no change. And you can prolong 3 counts, 4 counts, 5 counts, depending on the mode of recitation. Here, the last word is waw. Which is, you know, the raw is a consonant and followed by vowel, which is without, you know, any stroke, only skoon, and then it will be prolonged. Forget about the alif. Here, alif is just a silent. In this case, it's alif zayda. It's just a, because of some, we know that what is the, you know, significance of this one to make a difference between. Okay, Hasan, do this one.
وَإِن كُنتُمْ جُنُبًا فَاتَّحَّرُوا.
Good.
قُلِ اللَّهُ أَعْلَمُ بِمَا لَبِثُوا.
Well done. I am very pleased. Tha properly pronounced, and also Lamul Jalala has not been pronounced thick but thin because the previous letter Lam carries a kasra. Good. Zishan, next.
وَلَا يَجْرِمَنَّكُمْ شَنَآنُ قَوْمٍ عَلَىٰ أَلَّا تَعْدِلُوا.
Okay, well done. This Allah, La Mushaddad, will be pronounced thick or thin. There is a condition or just permanently thin or thick?
Thin.
Permanently thin, because it does not relate to La Mujlala. Okay. Last.
وَلْيَعْفُوا وَلْيَصْفَحُوا.
Okay, good. Well done. Case 4. There will be no change if a consonant is followed by ya madda. Before that, alif madda, we have given examples. You have recited, mashallah, very well, all. And vaw madda. And this is ya madda. It means the consonant followed by ya, sakin, and that will be prolonged up to 3 counts, 2 counts, 3 counts, 4 counts, whatever. And this is very beautiful example from the Holy Qur'an chapter, Surah Taha. Okay, beautiful prayer. Each verse is ending on ya sakin, and this is ya madda, letter of prolongation, ya of a letter of prolongation. So what you will do, you will read all or one by one? Okay, let's see two verses, one individual, per one individual.
قال رب اشرح لي صدري.
Say again.
قال رب اشرح لي صدري.
Okay.
One more.
ويسر لي أمري.
Okay, good. Next.
واحلل عقدة من لساني يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِي.
Well done. Next.
وَجْعَلْ لِي وَزِيرًا مِّنْ أَهْلِي هَارُونَ أَخِي.
Well done. Now Hassan, this is your turn, last two verses. Now tell me, this is a blank alif. Okay, this is a blank alif. Which stroke it will take?
Tamma.
What is the reason? What is the rule behind that?
Because the third letter has a dhamma.
So third letter, the first letter is blank alif, second is sheen, and the third letter is dal with a dhamma, and blank alif will take dhamma. Okay, do this one.
Ushdud bihi azri.
Dal qalqala. Ushdud.
Ushdud bihi azri. وَأَشْرِكْهُ فِي أَمْرِي.
Okay, good. So, رَبِّ شِرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي up to يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِي is very common, and it should be memorized and practiced and recited daily basis. Very, very important. In terms of recitation of the Holy Quran, in terms of learning the Holy Quran, teaching the Holy Quran, or any branch of knowledge, it is very, very important. It's very important prayer. Is a prayer of Prophet Moses, alayhis-salam. Case 5. There will be no change if a consonant is followed by harful lean. You see, there are only two letters of lean. Lean means easy, soft. And waw and ya. Provided there is a fatha before that. In this case, فَإِنْ أَسْلَمُوا فَقَدِهْتَدَوْا. Wow, sakin, and before that مَفْتُوح dal, or any letter with fatha, and there will be no change. It's just simple. And here you can also prolong, like 3 counts, 2 count, 3 count, four counts, soft prolongation. Okay, Hassan, do this.
فَإِنْ أَسْلَمُوا فَكَدِ اهْتَدَوْا.
Well done.
فَاسْتَقِمْ كَمَا أُمِرْتَ وَمَنْ تَابَ مَعَكَ وَلَا تَتْغَوْا.
Good. Disha.
وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا لَا تَسْمَعُوا لِهَذَا الْقُرْآنِ لا تسمعوا لهذا القرآن والغوا وأمروا بالمعروف ونهوا.
Okay, this is another example. See that line third. وقال الذين كفروا لا تسمعوا لهذا القرآن والغوا is one statement. And after that, وَالْغَوْ فِيهِ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَغْلِبُونَ. But this is another one, وَأَمَرُوا بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَنَهَوْ. This is not part of the third line. Okay, this is separate. That's why the prop, is. But I think because after وَالْغَوْ, there is no sign of a pause. That's why, But anyway, that's why I have put on different lines. Okay, that's good. Case 6, fatha will change into sukoon if the last letter is a consonant. If the last letter is a consonant and there is a fatha, that will be dealt as there is a jazm and sukoon on that one. Basically, kafara will be kafar. Kafar. Ra, a conditional sukoon will come because of the waqf. So, Hasan, do this.
فَبُهِتَ الَّذِي كَفَرْ.
Okay, next.
وَذُكُرْ فِي الْكِتَابِ مَرْيَمْ.
Okay, Ra, Sakin Ra, Maryam Ra, Sakin, before Fatha, thick. Thick, na? It's okay. Okay, good. Zishan, you do this. Third line.
لا يستوي منكم من أنفق من قبل الفتح وقاتل.
Good. Next, Hassan.
ما أغنى عنه ماله وما كسب.
Say again.
ما أغنى عنه ماله وما كسب.
Okay, good. Tell me the last line, ma aghna anhu maluhu wa ma kasab. Which surah is that? I'm asking this question because you have memorized last surahs, because this is a, you know, part of syllabus in Atfal al-Ahmadiyya, Khudam al-Ahmadiyya. This is a common first 17 verses, last 10 chapters. You know, this is a very common syllabus for everyone. And this is one of from the last 10 chapters.
Al-Lahab.
Surah Al-Lahab, yes, last page. Okay, good. Case 7. Kasra will change into sukoon if the last letter is a consonant. If the last letter with fatha, kasra, dhamma, it will change into a sukoon, a jazm. And here, Allahi, ha, with a kasra, and very beautiful, you know, part of kalima, and also has come in the Holy Qur'an here, Suratul Fath. Okay, do this one.
Muhammadur Rasulullah
sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Okay, just quick point to be remembered because this is just, you know, increase the interest in the Holy Qur'an, and sometimes a question as well. How many times the most beloved name, Muhammad, the Holy Prophet ﷺ's name, has been mentioned in the Holy Qur'an?
Four
times, yes, well done. And this is one, the last, okay, Muhammad Rasul. Four times the word Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam has been mentioned, and one Ahmad has been mentioned here. Okay, and many other attributes. Okay, next.
Wa antum aakifuna fil masajid.
Okay, good. Next, Dishan.
Inna as-salata tanha 'anil fahsha'i wal munkar.
Good. Last.
وَمِن شَرِّ النَّفَّاثَاتِ فِي الْعُقَدِ.
Which surah?
Yes, Al-Falaq.
Good. Surah Al-Falaq. Yes. Second last chapter, 113. Okay, good. Case 8. Dhamma will change into sukoon if the last letter is a consonant. You see, this is a case. There may be 100 examples. We have just, because of the shortage of time, only 4 examples have been given. But this is the case, and the other cases are coming. Sometime a verse is ending, or portion of a verse is ending on a mushaddad letter. Okay, how to do this one? Sometime, you know, different scenarios, different words. And we have to practice all, each and everything. Basically, wherever the in the words of the Holy Quran, each word, we should know how to make a pause on that one. Now, in these four examples, the last letter is with Dhamma, carrying with Dhamma. So, Hassan, this is your turn now.
Inna shaniyaka huwal abtar.
Okay, which surah?
Al-Kawthar.
Al-Kawthar, yes, good.
وَقُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقُّ وَزَهَكَ الْبَاطِلُ.
Okay. Wa is a separate word. Zahaqa is a separate word. Okay. A little small, you know, a difference in the pronunciation. So it should not be, you know, a person should not be thinking wazahaqa is one word. Wa zahaqa. Wa is a letter. Is a meaning with ant, is a conjunction, you know, is a connecting word. Okay, do again.
وَقُلْ جَاءَ الْحَقُّ وَزَهَقَ الْبَاطِلُ.
Batil, okay, good.
اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ.
Okay, Hassan.
وَلَذِكْرُ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرُ.
Okay. So these are the eight cases which we have learned today, very important rules of pauses, you know, and waqf and stop. So there will be no change if the last letter is sakin. Farghab, farghab. And if the last letter is alif madda, ata'na, ata'na. Waw madda. Labithu, labithu, same. Recap. Ya madda, Rabbi shirahli sadri, or many other, you know, examples you can find in the whole Holy Quran. And harful lean as well. Wow, and with the second letter is ya as well. And this is up to you if you can find an example which is ending on ya sakin and before there is a fatha on that. Okay, if you could find any example. Okay, and let me know. And if the last letter is a consonant and it carries either with fatha, kasra, dhamma, that will be a sakin. School. Okay, so it is very important that we know, and also important how to start. Like for example, verse number 32 here in Ushdud bihi Azri, and how the fatha will come or kasra will come, you know very well. For example, waj'alli waziram min ahli. Here, if you remove wa and you start from the next word, how would you start?
With kasra.
With kasra, yes, because the third letter carries a fatha. If it is a fatha or kasra, is ij'alli waziram min ahli. Well done. Okay. Any question?
So since you said this prayer is very important, we have cut it short. If you can recite the full.
Yeah, from Rabbish Rahli Sadri up to Yafqahu Qawli.
I mean, if you can do it for.
You can't?
I mean, if you can recite it together, because we have done it short.
Alright, okay. A'udhu billahi minash shaytanir rajim. Qala Rabbish Rahli Sadri. وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي وَحْلُلْ عُقْدَةً مِّن لِّسَانِي يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِي. So this is the prayer. You can continue up to وَجْعَلْ لِي وَزِيرًا مِّنْ أَهْلِي. You can also include in that one, depending on your situation. If you want a keen supporter from your family or friends, or you know, it's very good. Basically, and that prayer has been accepted, you know, we know that word. Harun akhi ushtud bi azri wa ashruku fi amri. Rabbi shrahli sadri, Lord, expand my mind. وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي and ease my task for me. وَحْلُلْ عُقْدَةً مِنْ لِسَانِي and ease the knot, you know, from my tongue. Remove every impediment from my tongue. يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِي so people may understand me fully. Very, very beautiful prayer. So this is conclusion of lesson 42. تَمَّتْ بِالْخَيْرِ كَانَ اللَّهُ مَعَكُمْ السَّلَامُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَرَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ وَبَرَكَاتُهُ
وَعَلَيْكُمْ السَّلَامُ
وَبَرَكَاتُهُ أَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَرَتِّلِ